Jana Jarman, with her speech titled 60, Just a Boy. With her speech titled 60, Just a Boy. Please welcome Jana Jarman.
Someone called Tom. He's 16. Is he old or young? It depends. If you're 20, to you he's probably old. If you say 100, he is just a boy. As people getting older, their view of age changes. I will show how it happened to me. As a young girl, I was growing and developing very fast. My parents and I were very happy to hear that at 5, I look like a 7-year-old. Would I be that happy now if you add 2 years to my age? Probably not. When I was 7, my father asked me if I enjoyed my school day. Very much so. We played hide and seek with some uncles. What? And where did you hide? In bushes. And where was your teacher? She went for lunch. Did you see the uncles before? Yes, in school, during the break. So they're walking in the school as well? Of course, they're pupils from the seventh form. Tomorrow I'm going to see your teacher. Talk about this game of yours, hide and seek in bushes with some uncles from the seventh form. One day, when I was 17, I returned from hairdresser with a huge hairdo, very fashionable at that time. My mother said, it looks very sophisticated, do you like it? No, it's horrible. It makes me look very old, almost 30. Do you think 30 is old? Not old, ancient. So if you're in your 30, see how some teenagers might perceive you. I also probably hurt my mother feeling, who was in her 40s and worried about her premature aging. Another case. When I was a student, I attended ballroom dances. I met another girl. She was very talkative and friendly, and she asked my age. I said, 18, and you? She said, 25. 25? Gosh, you're so old. You should be married by now and look after your kids, Ludwig, instead of dancing. Well, very soon you will be my age and older. I wish I was wrong, but alas, time flies. I also wish I read Dale Carnegie at the time about not hurting people's feelings. Once Auntie Lisa, who was 70, said, can you imagine? He called me babushka, granny. Of course, I pretended everything fine, but isn't it crazy to call me babushka? Thanks God, I did not say anything stupid or hurtful. I just smiled. But why now young people give up their seats for me in public transport more and more often? Of course, I prefer sitting rather than standing. But do I really look that old? Once in Odessa on the bus, a young man was staring at me. Probably I reminded him someone, maybe pop star. He came closer to me and saved this smile. Babushka! Am I Auntie Lisa now? Whenever you go, majority of the workforce in their 30s, what do these kids know about life? Can we really trust them, our health, finances, security? I hope they had good schooling, better than I observed here for the last 20 years. Also pay attention, 30 is not ancient to me anymore, more like kids or Boy Scouts. Talking about education, governments of a few countries get together to discuss how to improve education, to adjust the young the new skills so they can survive and be successful in this rapidly changing world. Due to longer life expectancy, retirement age is going up and up, and for today's kids, it will reach 90. So, in the same office, you will see people who are 70, 80, 90, 20, and in between. So we have to learn how to cooperate with each other. It could be beneficial if you use wisdom and experience of the older generation and combine it with energy of the young, but not overall. Don't you believe me, but you should. My neighbor in Odessa, he is 91, still working as university professor. My brother-in-law, in his 80s, still a school teacher, and he's not going to give up, and neither will I. You probably heard about Jack Reynolds from Chesterfield. In his 105, he's still practicing extreme sports. He has tattooed Jacob, 1912, where he was born, 1912. If you ask Jacob if Tom is old or young, he will say 60. Just a boy. Mr. Kardashian.